Okay, now same thing. Try and step towards the net, stare at the net, step and throw. Okay, try it again. Turn sideways, throw it hard, get it in. Oop, try again. Stare at that net. Yes, good one, high five. Good job.
So you've talked about the structure of certain sports as being potentially therapeutic for individuals with ADHD. Some people say that individual sports are better suited for an ADHD athlete than team sports. Would you agree with this?
I think there's a potential, particularly untreated ADHD, if it's a team sport, to have an impact on the team, say, practices, particularly with youth athletes. But I think in general that being involved in organized sports, to me, is much more of a positive than a negative.
Some athletes have actually described their ADHD as being an asset to their sport, particularly professional golfers, who say that they find that they thrive under extreme pressure, and they believe that it's their ADHD symptoms, or those who have actually been diagnosed, the brain's capacity to hyper-focus when under extreme pressure. Is that tendency accurate?
No, that's just wrong. Because the ability to hyperfocus is not ADHD. Because you have a diagnosis of ADHD doesn't mean you might not have other skills, and we see that. It's what we see is the core symptoms of ADHD would not improve a golfer. In fact, they would go quite the opposite direction. The fact that golfers with ADHD might have the capacity to hyperfocus and do well doesn't mean that they would lose that. I've had athletes actually tell me, you know, oh, I'm afraid of getting treated. I said, well, it's up to you, but they get treated, they actually get much better. So the idea that ADHD improves performance is really someone who doesn't understand what the illness, the disease is.
Psychologist Edward Hallowell, who is also co-author of the book Driven to Distraction, says that he thinks golf is the ideal ADD sport. And he says, you get a fresh opportunity every time, so it's one surprise after another. The combination of structure, novelty, and motivation, wherever you find that, the mind tends to focus. He has ADHD himself, and he says that if he could snap his fingers and be cured, that he wouldn't do it because it would deplete him of other desirable qualities. And I'm guessing you might disagree with him.
No, that's just wrong. There's no data to demonstrate someone's individual, that if you lose, it's like saying, well, having cancer really made me a better person. If I'm cured of my cancer, I'm going to be a bad person again. That would be a similar analogy. ADHD impairs functioning by definition. Eliminating something that impairs functioning is not likely to improve it. The fact that people have, one could say the same in tennis, each point's a new point. I mean, can golfers do better with this? But I think this concept that this disease might in fact make you better at something is just flat out wrong.
So what do you feel are some of the primary struggles that athletes with ADHD and their coaches face?
The fact that they're not really understood, that they're not lazy, they're not committed, that they really are. It's not that they're trying to disrupt, that people don't understand their core disabilities, that it's not that they don't want to concentrate, that they don't want to, you know, have problems with distractibility, but they just can't. And people who don't have it say, no, just focus on something else. So I think it's the frustration that I've seen in athletes that, you know, I didn't choose this. I don't want to be this way. I would love to be able to stay right on task, stay focused, be able to read the playbook once and know what it's like. And I think it's that level of frustration, knowing that I have the talent and this, that I just can't do it. And that's where I think dealing with that frustration factor becomes so important, and why I get so disturbed and annoyed when people come out and say, no, well, my ADHD has made me better at this. No, you would be far better if you didn't have it, just like you would be better if you had any other disease that was treated.
And that struggle to keep up and fit in can be at the expense of the fun. So what suggestions would you make to coaches and parents to help maintain the fun and help these athletes keep up and fit in?
I think it's a very important point that you raise here, and coaches need to know, because ADHD folks tend to be good talkers, not necessarily great listeners. They'll say, I'll pick you up on my cell in a couple of minutes, and then they forget. Well, it's not that they don't care, but they just forget. They lose their keys, they lose their cell phones. It's really part of some of the core symptoms. So I think what's important is educating the parents. Now, that's usually not a big deal because almost always at least one of the parents will have had, if not diagnosed ADHD symptoms. Gets back to what we mentioned earlier about the strong genetic loading for it. But having coaches, youth coaches, understand what it's like so that they can work with the strengths and some of the issues that aren't so strong in an ADHD athlete. Not putting them in a position where they need sustained focus and concentration, playing to their strengths and understanding that. Not to make them necessarily ADHD specialists, but understanding and being able to work with the athlete so that they can maximize not only the enjoyment, but their athletic performance.
Your film, Well Played, illustrates how parents can sometimes grow frustrated when their child is on a team with an athlete who struggles with ADHD symptoms, such as the hyperactivity, invasion of others' personal space, and what appears to be a disregard of team rules. And the parents can then grow impatient with the coach for how they handle these situations. I would think it's hard for a coach to deal with disgruntled parents while also trying maybe to maintain the privacy of the athlete whose family may not want their diagnosis disclosed.
Yeah, having been a youth sports coach for many years, this is a big issue. I mean, the most difficult thing in youth sports coaching is not coaching the kids, it's dealing with the parents. I think every youth sports coach will probably tell you that. But I think what we see and what we tried to bring out in that film that we did, which was actually based on my own experiences over many years coaching youth soccer, and I was a soccer player myself many years ago, was that the issue is understanding strengths and weaknesses. So if you have a child who's not particularly fast, maybe you wouldn't want to put him in a position where it requires a lot of running, say up on the front line. Maybe they have wonderful hand-eye coordination, but they have not such good fitness. Maybe they might make a good goalkeeper. And I think what we see and what I try to bring out in the film is to understand the strengths and work with the strengths and deal with the areas that might be a deficit or an area that isn't so strong. So I think this is where we get into educating coaches, educating parents without violating personal information, but understanding that sports is all about working to your highest level of performance and that realizing that certain things we can adapt to, other things we can. So I think it really gets back to educating coaches in an appropriate way and parents in a way that is still respectful of personal information.
Next, we're going to talk about the future of ADHD and research and where you think it's headed.